Hi guys, welcome back. My name is The Gaming Blake, and it's been a while since I've been on this channel. A lot has happened in the last couple of while. Hang on, let me rock back on my squeaky chair here. So basically, I just wanted to make this little video before the actual video starts, just to explain what's happened, for those who don't know, or for those of you who need to be updated on what's actually happening. Basically, what's happened is that YouTube deleted my channel, and it kind of sucked, really, and but I didn't want to stop. I stopped for a little while after my channel was suspended. If you're asking why it was suspending, I have no clue. They didn't actually tell me, they just told me I was suspended for breaking terms and services. Then when they actually reviewed it, they realized that I haven't done anything wrong, but I'll get to that bit. So it was suspended, so what I decided to do was go to a new channel, and instead of carrying on where I left off, because I wouldn't get as many of you guys subscribing to the old channel, because I don't follow a lot of you on social media yet, because I don't use it often. The only way I was able to contact you was through the YouTube comment section, but if I couldn't access my account, I couldn't exactly contact you. So I was unable to obviously tell a lot of you about the changeover. Those who did find out obviously did subscribe to that channel, and I'm grateful for that. Thank you so much. But yeah, so a couple of days ago, I got an email saying that they've looked over it and saying that there's nothing wrong with my channel. Must have been a mistake or something, and they have unsuspended it. But of course, that doesn't mean I'm on thin ice still, because the fact it's been suspended once is really going to put a damp on things, I guess. But so yeah, so now I'm back and hopefully going to be subscribing on this channel. So carrying on this channel. So So I thought I'd just explain what's happening with World Internet Wrestling. Everything else is going to carry on as normal. I might restart a couple of other series, maybe start a proper career. I don't know. I went to do one with Leicester, but I never actually came around doing it. Might be bringing you guys some NBA stuff, maybe, because I love NBA personally. I love playing the game. I've got NFL, like Madden and stuff. I've got loads of games. Anything you guys want me to play, let me know and I will give it a go. Any of your favorite games or whatever, even if it's not on here, if it's on the iPhone or something, let me know and I will give it a go. But as regards to World Internet Wrestling, here's what's happened. When I went to the new channel, I restarted it as if the titles had not been given out before. What I did was, and you'll see in this video, I kind of explain it in my little promo section at the beginning, but you'll see, is that everybody who has been a champion in the past competed for the right to be the first true champion. And that's what I'm kind of stick with. I was thinking of carrying on from where we left off from GamesCon there, but I've already done four new videos and storylines are going on there, and you guys are really into it, the guys who are subscribing on the other channel. So what I've decided to do is move it over to this channel. So what you're going to see now, for those who haven't seen it, is the first four episodes, not all at once, I'm going to upload them when I can, but the first four episodes from the old channel, bring it onto the new one, and then once they're over here, I'm going to get rid of that old new channel, don't need it anymore, so I'll go back on to the Gaming Blake full time, and we will carry on from there. The only problem with the restart was is that I didn't get all of your characters, because the network is shit on WWE. Those who play it, you know what I mean. The network is terrible. It's impossible to find your characters using your hashtags. So if your character is an old person in the series, such as, I don't know, Brandon X or something like that, the first name that popped off my head, if you're involved in the series and you really want to still be a part of it and you want to come back into the universe, please contact me in the comment section. My Twitter is TheGamingBlake, so you should be able to find me if you type that in. Yeah, or contact me any other way, but just let me know what's happening in the comment section if you do want to come back into the series. I know this is really inconvenient, and trust me, it's a little bit confusing in the series, because watching back the episodes, it's a bit confusing, but the basis of it all, like if I was to sum it all up, GamesCon still happened. Everything that happened at GamesCon still happened. The brand split didn't happen. Everything before GamesCon happened. It's just like the universe reset. It's a new era, if you will, like the original one was. It's a new era, and we have done it like that. So it's confusing, I know, but hopefully you guys don't mind it, and I hope you guys are looking forward to me bringing new content to you guys, and hopefully try and get a bit more face cam. I don't know if this is the first time on this channel, because I've had channels before. I don't know if this is the first time on this channel that you've seen my face, but if it is, hi, I'm the Gaming Blake. So yeah, this was really long and I rambled on a bit, so I can't imagine many of you listened to this, but I just wanted to clarify for anyone who needed clarification. We'll just carry on to the video now. So I hope you enjoyed this video and enjoy the other videos. Can't wait to get back on the way with this channel. Love you guys so much. Be sure to subscribe and like if you understand or if you're enjoying the series, and I will talk to you guys later. Peace.
Shut up and sit down.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to World Internet Wrestling! We are finally back online and it is finally ready for you to view here on the brand new network. Be sure to subscribe to the new network and press that like button if you are happy to see this series return on this new network. Apologies, the old network was taken down and suspended by, of course, our partners YouTube, and if we do not have YouTube support, then we do not have World YouTube and World Internet Wrestling support either. So we've made some new changes for the final, and I mean final, restart of this series, one of which is, as you may notice, I'm wearing a suit. And there's a reason I am wearing this suit. It's because I am stepping down from wrestling for the time being, and I am acting as the CEO, owner, and general manager of this company for the time being. As much as I love the wrestling and as much as I can enjoy competing for that world title, someone needs to get a firm grip on this show, which tonight is kicking off in a big fashion. Every single person who has held a title in the past will compete for a title opportunity. Well, not compete for the title opportunity because they've already got it, duh. But they will be competing tonight for the titles, and you will see the card as it goes along, who is competing in what. But we have some great matches on display. We've got some incredible returning superstars, featuring some new superstars, of course, across the way. And I can't wait to get you guys back into this series. So without further ado, let's find out who the true champions really are of this series. Thank you guys so much. I love seeing you all. Let's make this series a good one. Finally, we are back, and it's the first match of the series, and it is for the television championship. Three past champions will compete to be the true champion. And the first man down to the ring, it's Sal Games, and it's a big one for him. He was the last champion before Tyson Jackson took over in an epic match at Gamescom, for those who remember that match. That match that ended in the crowd as it escalated pretty much, well, like wildfire. It was crazy how much that match escalated. And now Sal Games coming to take back what he believes is rightfully his in the television championship. Remember, whoever gets this, that's it. Everyone else has lost their history as champion, and whoever wins this is the first ever champion that is true to this series and true to the channel. It's awkward, I know, and it's uncomfortable for those of you who have seen these title matches already, but it's new, it's improved, and hopefully we're going to make this into a much more entertaining series if YouTube is going to let us. Second man down to the ring, a familiar face, but what a new look. It is Travis. Travis, during the switchover to the new network, or channel as I'm calling it, we had Travis come into a bit of money, as you can see. A very wealthy man he is indeed now, and as you can see, what do you do with money? You become a cowboy. I mean, it worked for JBL, so that is what Travis is feeling here. So Travis showing off his wealth
with some really expensive clothing. How he came into that money, we do not know yet. We do not know. That is yet to be revealed. Just want to say at this point, if you're experiencing any lag, that's also happening on this end. Don't worry about that. You know how good the servers usually are on this game, even though we're not online, which confused me. But I'm going to try and break the fourth wall a little less this series, but I'm already off to a terrible start. But Travis, on his way down to the ring, the first ever television championship on the last series. So it's a matter now of whether this series he can come in and be the first ever true television champion. So it's a very big moment here for World Internet Wrestling. He looks like he's confident. So let's see if he can pull it off tonight here. The man with the money now, Travis Cottrell, and a very different look, but you can see it's the same old Travis with the same hair and similar beard. But here comes another man we're all familiar with, and it is the Dragon himself, Tyson Jackson, the last ever television champion, coming back today with a new look, in a new attire, and a new entrance, as you will see now. Tyson Jackson, the television champion, had a very long-lasting rival, well, say a long-lasting rivalry, because it was cut short, a rivalry cut short between him and Sal Games, in which he managed to get the championship. He is the last ever champion, and for those of you who are new to the series, brace yourself, because this is one hell of a character. Ladies and gentlemen, Tyson Jackson. And here he is in all of his glory, not wearing the title. Why? Don't know. I wouldn't be able to tell you, I'm afraid. But that is what has been given to us. That's what's been granted. But that is it. Tyson Jackson here coming down with a chainsaw. Very, very interesting choice. So we now have the Cowboy, the Dragon, and the former champion himself, Sal Games. It's going to be interesting to see how this goes back. These three, all regular subscribers and regular comments, regular in the comment section of the last video. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens for the future of these three characters. But it's time, ladies and gentlemen, to finally get back underway. And it's finally time to get back into World Internet Wrestling. And it's time to crown the first ever World Internet Wrestling Television Champion for the new series. And possibly here on onwards, you never know how long a title reign would last in this series. They haven't proved to last very long in the old series. But let's see if they can keep this run going and see if someone can get a run going as a true champion. Travis, Sal, and Tyson Jackson for the Television Championship. Opening night of the show. Let's get this on the way and straight away. Oh, and Sal Games just decides to slip out of the ring and get himself out of the way. And Travis is going to go to work. Oh, and now Travis is going to go. And look at this. Travis off to a very good start here. Travis doing very, very well. Oh, but wait a minute. Tyson Jackson not going to let him carry this momentum. Went for the kick. Dodged by Travis. And an intense battle in the ring while Sal tactically just lets them fight it out. Oh, and a light little back breaker there. I was tempted to say it's not. Oh, and wait a minute. Sal Games. He's going to have a go at Travis. And Travis not going to let him. Travis having a run at him. Oh, he kind of ran into him there. And now they're both after Travis. We're getting the momentum. And Tyson Jackson takes both Sal and Travis down. And now Travis, oh wait a minute, oh, Tyson Jackson trying to get the better of him, couldn't, and now sweep from behind by Sal Games, went for the clothesline, Travis into a belly-to-belly suplex by Sal Games, and now Sal Games in control as Travis is going for to try and get up from the outside there, rolled out the way, and now Tyson Jackson doing some damage in the ring. Sal Games being tactical here, coming in and out, taking his time to bring, oh, and a huge kick to the back of the head, and Travis is just watching, and he's just gonna take the time to taunt while Sal Games and Tyson Jackson battle it out in the middle of the ring. Oh, and a lovely shout out there by Tyson Jackson. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, and Tyson Jackson went to continue to just sort of, well, reversed by Tyson Jackson, the current champion. And now he's going to continue his assault on Sal Games. Wait a minute, Sal Games with a spine buster to get this back into the... And now he's going for Travis. Oh, and a neck breaker. And now Tyson Jackson out of the ring. And now Sal Games is going to try and do something. And Sal Games going for the early submission hold. Travis in trouble here. But Travis has managed to get out of it. Oh, and now going for a running clothesline and reversed again by Sal Games. style games, enjoying himself here, as you can see. Oh, and Tyson Jackson now, he's not going to let him do that, and a nice little cutter there from Tyson Jackson. Went for Travis, and Travis is able to reverse. Oh, but now he's reversed, and now Tyson Jackson looking to get control. He's going for a submission hold. And now Travis once again in trouble, already been weakened here. And now Travis is struggling. But wait a minute. Great strength, lifts him up and slams him down. Good display of strength there from Travis. Picks up Tyson Jackson. Scoops him up, but Jackson reverses with the help of Sal Games. And now Sal Games, oh, once again, hip toss. And Travis outside of the ring, he goes. Meanwhile, Sal Games going to continue the assault on Tyson Jackson. Remember, the reason these guys are tearing each other apart is for their television championship. These two will do whatever the hell they have to do. These three will do whatever they have to do to get that title. Tyson Jackson dodging the kick there. Sal Games, this has been one hell of a start. Full blazing since the opening bell. And now Sal Games, hold on a minute. Sal Games could be looking for the DDT. DDT! That massive DDT. And now Sal Games is getting going. But wait a minute, Travis, not going to let him get the momentum. He might try and go for Jackson here and steal a cover. He picks him up instead. Could be looking to send him down with a power slam, unable to do so. And now Tyson Jackson, he's going to try and take advantage. Oh, and a big code breaker to the back, or back break, or whatever it is. You guys know I'm terrible with the names in this game. Oh, wait a minute. What's he going for here? Picks him up. Oh, and a power bomb. Sal Games, it could be over. Travis needs to break it up. It's over. Sal Games is the champion. Once again, Sal Games recaptures the WIW Television Championship, and he destroyed Tyson Jackson in doing so. A huge DDT and into a huge powerbomb pin from and Travis. Look, you can see there from Sal, and you can see Travis trying to crawl to get it, but it's a huge victory nonetheless. Sal Games is the first television champion of the series. And the brawler, Sal Games, is once again the champion. A huge victory for Sal Games. And Sal celebrating a huge victory here tonight. Congratulations to Sal Games. And wait a minute. Look at Sal Games doing. Sal Games with a chair there. Cameraman's being very glitchy with his camera work there. And he's going for the chair shot, but wait a minute. Original Brad, Travis's tag team partner, to the rescue. Thank God for that. Wait a minute. He just struck him with the chair. Original Brad has just struck his own tag team partner with the chair. What on earth is going on right now? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry to tell you that we're going to have to carry on moving down the card. No time to figure out what just happened after watching Brad attacking his own tag team partner following his television championship loss to Sal Games. But here comes a new tag team on the block for this first tag team match of the evening. It is John Cutter and El Murica. John Cutter, a new superstar to the roster. El Murica, a returning superstar to the roster. Both made by, of course, Brendan Plays. So the team from Brendan's Plays is coming down to the ring. I haven't decided on a name for them yet, but right now John Cutter and Erica and El Murica are making their tag team debuts, and they will be taking on the returning up, up, down, down of Xavier Woods, or Austin Creed, and El Murpho. And that is all in a warm-up before the tag team championship match of the Wolfpack look to try and defend and claim the tag team championships from the only other tag team champions that there have ever been, the Cottrell family. So this should be an interesting one. These two look ready for this one. It's going to be interesting to see how they compete here in World Internet Wrestling. We know from past experiences it's not always the easiest thing to do. But here comes some fan favorites now. It amazes me how Big E still introduces them. But here they come, returning off of not the best of starts in the last series. Austin Creed and El Murpho, up, up, down, down, now coming down to the ring, hoping to improve on what was a very shaky start to their World Internet Wrestling's last time out. And here they come. New Day entrance, and they're looking very happy, both rocking some up-up-down-down gear there. El Murfo with a very new updated up-up-down-down attire, which is very, very nice for him. Embracing the spirit of World Internet Wrestling and trying to leave us, trying to bring out Austin Creed rather than Xavier Woods. El Murfo had quite a successful singles career, actually. Not managing to clinch a title, but came very close to in the Money in the Bank match. But unfortunately for him, he couldn't grab it. But now it's about some tag team action. El Murica and Austin Creed gonna start this one off, so let's see how it goes. And straight away into a side slam onto the knee there is Austin Creed. I've got to try and not call him Xavier Woods. It's so tempting, because I'm looking at Xavier Woods. Oh, and a discus clothesline to get on the way there from El Murica. El Murica looking slightly taller than I remember him to be. Maybe he's been spending his time trying to sort out the contract to get back into World Internet Wrestling, but also to, you know, go to the gym, work out, try and, I don't know, get some protein in him to reverse. Oh, had a minute reversal there. And into a suplex. And might be looking for an early tag here to bring in John Carter, but Austin Creed's getting up, got in his way there, it looked. And now some athleticism from him there. And very nice stuff already from El Murica. Very impressive competitor, El Murica. Never quite had any success because his last tag team partner was probably one of the worst wrestlers that ever entered this business in El Huracan, with only one win ever. And here comes John Cutter now, making his first appearance on the show in a super kick. And Austin Creed is going to tag in El Murfo for his first taste on this new network. For those of you who are new to the series, bear in mind that we did do a series on my old channel. My old channel got suspended from YouTube, but I'm just gonna try and keep it realistic, okay? Oh, and a great little pickup there into a fireman's carry and slams him down. And very nice stuff there. I called that fireman's carry, it wasn't. Also, if you're new to the channel, you'll realize my commentary really sucks. Anyway, oh, a nice little bit of athleticism there into the Hurricane Runner. And now just gonna stomp on him before picking him up. And we're off to a good start here. Very fast pace. Series of punches and kicks here from El Murfo. Wear him in down, and the crowd are loving it. And now, John Cutter takes him up to the top rope. Oh, reversal by El Murfo. He could be looking to fly here. Crossbody. And that's very nice indeed from El Murfo. He's off to a good start here. And now, grabs him by the head. And to a handstand, just tightening down the head, wearing down John Cutter. And he thinks that could be enough. The first cover of the night. No, and it's only a one count. And of course, these two teams, this isn't a number one contender match, but they want to show that they can beat serious tag team competitors.
Game,
right now, the tag team division
huge victory
is very, very
tonight
slim.
In the triple threat.
Hold on a minute, if they can get something going. Hold on a minute.
The cameraman's glitching out a
beautiful
little bit.
Beautiful move.
But Sal Games, he's
beautiful
got a chair on the ring,
and now he's
going
to attack Travis.
And
chase the referee out of the ring. Oh, wait a minute,
already.
There's Brad to the rescue.
El Murfo
and Travis'
in
tag team partner comes to
him
his rescue.
Corner.
Oh, wait a minute! Wait a minute!
Wait a minute!
Travis has just been attacked now by Brad! What's going on?
Down as it is now.
Original Brad has just attacked his own tag team partner!
And stomping viciously there is Austin Creed. In comes El Murfo. He's going to have a turn again. And this is very nice stuff here. John Cutter is in serious trouble.
We're going to finish it off with a shotgun dropkick. There it is, Unicorn Stampede. And that could be enough. Austin Creed, he's going to make the cover. Cover one. Oh, what? A one? That's pretty impressive resiliency there from John Cutter. Kick up at one. And Austin Creed begging him to get up. Cutter back to his feet. Goes for the springboard. Oh, beautiful drop kick. And the punishment that Cutter is receiving is not giving him positivity coming into his career. And hold on a minute. More tag team action here as El Murfo's tagged back in. Beautiful move there. And these two are doing very, very well. He's going to go for a cover, but went against it. Could have ended it there, just decided against it. And now he's going to go for an apron springboard, and he misses. And John Cutter now looking to display some offense, but he probably should get out of there. Looking to make the tag? He is making the tag. He didn't seem too sure about that one. But El Murica is in. And now the two acrobatic flyers going to get going here. El Murica. Oh,
John Carter was ready to throw him over the ropes there, but he saved him there and into a, in a Hurricane Rana. And now looking for a springboard, and he's missed there. The athleticism not quite as quick as El Murphy on that occasion. But this is a good display from up, up, down, down. Got off to a shaky start, as they usually do, but they aren't picking up the momentum. And El Murphy now just going to work away on Mr. El Murica. There's a lot of L's in this, you know. El Murica, El Murfo. Used to be El Hurricane. I'm sure there'll be another L somewhere. Someone will do like El Diablo or something. Anyway, moving on. Oh, and a nice little leg sweep there just to get himself out of trouble. It looks like he's going to tag back in John Carter. Oh, and he leaves with a chop. Oh, wait a minute. They might be looking to do some tag team action there. Kick to the gut. Oh, and a double suplex onto that turnbuckle. Very nice stuff. And John Carter now has the opportunity to take advantage. Picks him up and tosses him over. A great display of strength. And he senses he's in control, you feel. And chucks him into the corner. A reversal by El Murfo. And now looking to re-establish control. Irish whip to the corner. And now what's he thinking here? More tag team action here. Brings him down on the legs. Referee isn't even looking. He's too busy looking at El America. And here we go. We go for another cover. This could be enough. One, two. No, it's saved at the count of two by El America. Needed to come in and help his tag team partner. What a leg sweep. And now he could be looking to turn the tide. Every time the tide turns, the crowd are going crazy. And a reversal battle right now. Dropkick by Austin Creed. And now he's going to the top rope. He's looking for a splash. What's he thinking? Oh no, he's calling him up. He's calling him up. What's he thinking? Dropkick. And now playing to the crowd. He senses he's in control. And chant of the New Day rocks coming from the crowd. The crowd are loving this right now. John Carter trying to crawl to his partner, trying to make the tag. Oh, but wait a minute. No, he's trying to turn the tide once again. This has been a very back and forth match. Mainly dominated by up, up, down, down, but trying to get back in some control. DDT there from Austin Creed. And now, hold on a minute. Oh, with an arm drag there. Trying to get back in control of this one. And now John Carter. Irish whip once again to the corner. He's looking to do something here. He has been for a while. What's he planning to do? Oh, he's going to pick him up. He's going to put him on top. What's John Carter got in mind here? Oh, reversal by Creed. Creed now. Hurricane Rana into a cover. And that could be enough if he gets this one quick. Two. And it's only a two count. Carter manages to kick out. Oh, wait a minute. And he was taunting, but El Murica was just going to leave a cheap shot there for him. Couldn't stay in there for much longer. But Creed sensing the end coming. Austin Creed sensing this one is over. Oh, brings him down to one knee. Shining Wizard. The move that made this man famous. And into the cover. Surely this has done it. One, two, three. No, it's only a two count. And despite El Murfo stopping El Murica from getting involved and breaking up the pin, it was still kicked out by John Carter, who's showing him remarkable resiliency. And he's still going in this one, refusing to give up. Irish whip to the corner again. John Carter, a former prisoner of the Illinois Correctional, as you can see there, as it says on his back of the shirt. And now he's finally going for it. He's been looking to do this for a while, but now he's looking to do it. Tosses him off that. And look at the distance that went from one side of the ring to the other. And now John Carter trying to re-establish some control here. Let's get him in the corner. What are they thinking? Hold on a minute. G9-1! What a move! And that might steal it! John Carter stopping El Murfo from getting involved, but El Murfo to the rescue. G9-1, and that nearly won it there. An impressive tag team move from the Brendan Plays characters. And now El Murica looking to get some momentum of his own. Looking for a suplex, And it turns into a neck breaker from Austin Creed. John Cutler looking very worn out and tired on that rope over there, as you can see in the distance. Hold on a minute. And now looking to roll him up. We're going to roll him up. He's into a cover. And John Cutler is not ready to come and get him. I mean, it's only a two count. And the New Day Rocks chants continue to spread across the crowd. Austin Creed with a throw into the corner. Thank you for spending your money night. Hesitates a bit there, but what's he thinking? Once again, these two back in the ring. Hold on a minute. What are they thinking? Magic Killer! Xavier Woods just did the Magic Killer! And a cover! It's over! No! It still wasn't enough, but why? Why did Austin Creed, of all people, just do the Magic Killer? What an interesting choice. And now off Murpho. He's going top rope. Oh, he's missed. Elmerica able to get up. I'm in shock. This match is crazy. I don't even know what is happening. And now, looking to put him away. Beautiful move. Into a cover. It could be enough. Creed's not coming to his rescue. Could this be the win? No, it's only a two count. Creed was confident that that was going to be a kick out. Clearly. I don't know what's happening in this one. This is too freaking topsy-turvy. I have no clue how this is going to end. Cutter and Elmerica have really turned the tide since, of course, the G9-1. And then the Magic Killer was hit by, of all people, up, up, down, down, and Xavier Woods. Hold on a minute. Oh, wait a minute. Could be looking for that. That shotgun sliding there. Drive-by. Oh, wait, no, into a DDT. A very acrobatic display. And this is brilliant display here of resiliency. But looks dazed there at Elmerica. And now taunting the man down flat on the floor. Wait a minute, Murpho gets up. Count of four by the referee. Remember, there is count out on in this match. And Elmerica is going to bring it back into the ring. But he's going to take a minute before he gets back in. And now Elmerica. Kick to the gut. Maybe he could be looking to roll him up. Rolls him up and into a cover again. One. Two. He might be able to steal it here. Oh, and it's only a two count again. Whoa, whoa, wait. What's going on over there? John Cutter attacking Austin Creed. And the referee's not even doing anything about it. And this is a vicious assault over there. Oh! And a backbreaker. But wait a minute. Elmerica looking to take advantage. Beautiful move. Flatliner. And John Carr wasn't able to save his partner. This match is incredible. This is why I love doing this series. For matches like this, this is truly one for the ages right now. And Elmerica refusing to give up as well. Picks him up. Looking for it again. Beautiful move. And this time it could be enough. One. Two. No, it's still not enough. Still managed to kick out Elmerica, refusing to give in. But Elmerica, top rope, beautiful stomp. A moon stomp there, and into the cover. Surely it's over. Creed nowhere near to be in. And it's over. John Cutter and Elmerica pick up a huge debut victory as a tag team. Unbelievable display from them of resiliency. It wasn't their fight to win after Unicorn Stampedes, Magic Killers, and beautiful tag team display all around from up, up, down, down. But in the end, it was this moon stomp that won it for Elmerica and John Cutter. An impressive tag team debut victory for these two in what was one hell of a match. What a match victory for these two. I'm going to sneeze in a second. I'm going to try and move over it before we cut to the next match. But John Cutter and Elmerica pick up a huge tag team victory. Can they now work towards getting themselves a tag team match? And for the tag team titles, that means, well, we'll soon see. But for now, let's go and see who the tag team champions are about to be. It's time for the tag team championship. Well, it's finally time to bring out the tag champions. First, though, we're going to introduce the contenders. Coming down to the ring, the only other former tag team champions in any series we have done of this. And here come the Cotrells. Brett and Mad Max. No longer just Max, it is Mad Max these days. And it's for the tag team championship in this one. A regular one fall to the count tag team match. Very good competitors are the Cottrells, former tag team champions, as I say. And of course, their brother was a former television champion. Cottrell family, very strong competitors in this series, of course. Travis not looking so strong tonight, losing in the television championship matchup against Sal Games and Titan Jackson, and of course getting beaten by his own tag team partner. But these two, a very strong tag team, they have been from start to finish, and they look out for each other, that is much for sure, and they are one scary tag team. But I tell you what, there's only one team that's scarier than these two, and if it is that anyone, it's these three. These three, I was trying to do some dramatic there. Oh, fuck's sake! Oh, my days, it's the wrong intro. Of course it is, because we can't have one episode without any problems or bugs and glitches from WWE. But here they are, for those of you who haven't seen them before, the Wolfpack. King Sam, of course, the one to the left, the supposed leader of the group. Don't ask me why we're doing this animation, why they have the theme music on, and they, I don't know. But Lanky Steve in the middle, and David to the right, the current tag team champions. They are the Wolfpack. They are, if any of you are new to the series, the most dominant tag team that's ever been in this series, the most dominant force individually. And their story goes back quite a bit, but tonight they're trying to make history and become the first ever tag team champions for the series. We're going to ignore the entrance this week. Next week we'll bring out their actual intro. That's really annoying. I hate when the game does that. And the tag team championships on the line tonight. The Wolfpack and the Cottrells have had an interesting history with each other.
At a combined weight of 530 pounds, Brett and Mad Dog Max.
And the Cottrells looking ready to try and get them titles around them waists. But they have to take on the Wolfpack. The Wolfpack, current champions, the team that everybody loves to hate, the team that you have no real choice but to fear. Then this is what it's all for, the tag team titles. And remember, after this, every single bit of history is wiped. No other champions would be crowned after tonight, so Sal Games is the first ever television champion. Who will be the first tag team champion? And a big knee to start off. And we are straight in here with this matchup. And Steve, not taking any time to waste. And a big suplex there. And Steve, of course, an amazing 6'7" in height. A very tall competitor. Oh, and he's taunting already. Oh, but he isn't going to let any momentum go the Cottrell's way. Punches and kicks into his own corner. Oh, and a big reversal there by Steve. And not letting any momentum happen, but David's already in the ring. David is not waiting around to let anything happen that isn't going to end up with them in the title. A quick cover, looking to wrap it up, and it's only a two count. And this is a lethal display early on from the Wolfpack, as we've come to expect from them these days. Oh, wait a minute, Brett now. Looking to get momentum. Brett, an incredible 400-pound competitor, one of the heaviest competitors we have, in one of the very few in the super heavyweight class, and using that body strength of his just to wear down the shoulder. And in comes Mad Max, the smallest competitor that we have in this business. Oh, and he reverses that. Oh, and he continues to assault, but I don't think he realized that Mad Max was tagged in. He just knocks down the referee there, and a huge display of strength from Max Cottrell to lift up Steven there. No easy feat. Oh! And a nice move there. And he might look to make the first tag of the night. Instead, he picks him up. He goes against it, it looks. Irish whip. And a shot! And now he's going to tag in David. Who's going to go get to work? King Sam refusing to intervene by the seams of it. Oh, he's going to the top turner. Top turner. And he's thrown off anyway. It doesn't really matter if I speak poor English. Leg sweep there. Reversal. Oh, and a big slash. And into a cover straight away goes David. One. And it's only a one count. A shot to the head. Several shots to the head. And the Wolfpack are just dominating. But now, Max trying to get himself back into this. Oh, a big reversal by David. And this has just been a brutal assault so far. Bringing him back to his feet. Oh, wait a minute. Reversal by Mad Max. And Mad Max now, he's going to look to try and get some offense going. Huge suplex and a lot of strength for such a little man. And now could be looking to bring in his older brother. Max, the youngest of all the Cotchalls. Brett, the middle man. And, of course, Travis being the oldest, of course, by the last... by 2 years difference, I'd say. Not that that really matters as such. And as the Cotchalls are getting momentum, back David springs up, went for the kick to the gut, misses, and a clothesline. And now the Cotchalls are in control. Now looking to do some offense here in the corner. Might have been looking for a tag move. David weren't going to allow it. And now he's going to send him to his own corner. And now looking to tag in Steve for a bit of tag team work here. And going to just crash him into the turnbuckle as Steve gets himself into this matchup. Playing to the crowd again. The Wolfpack sensing they're in control early on here. And a DDT. They know they're in control. And they're taking full advantage of it. But wait a minute. Oh, scratching in the face. And crashing into the corner. And this has just been a non-stop domination. Oh, and now splashing him down into a mini powerbomb there off that bottom rope. And this has been an incredible display right now from the Wolfpack. And now what are the Wolfpack looking to do here? Are they going to go for a Magic Killer as well? For the second time tonight, Magic Killer. And into the cover. The Wolfpack might just wrap this one up really quickly. Oh, and it's only a two count. Oh, and David coming to help his tag team partner out here. And now the Wolfpack running amok in here. Oh, wait a minute. David just going to take the onslaught a bit further. Oh, and a big Samoan driver. A drop, sorry. What I meant to say. Now David, he's going to pick up the legal man. And he might look to lay some offense down himself. Oh, and a headbutt. And now looking for the neck breaker. Oh, onto the knee. Oh, and now David looking for a bit of offense. Could be looking for it. Powerbomb onto that knee. And that is some serious damage. This might already be over. But it's not. Oh! And using that body mass to his advantage. Oh, and he's run away now. He needed to get out of here. Irish whip to the corner and now looking for some more tag team moves. Now what are they thinking? Are they going for it again? Brett's in the ring, but he's not helping out. Another Magic Killer. And it could be all over into the cover. One, two, no, and the Wolfpack still haven't done it. This match still isn't over. Oh, wait a minute. Max springs back to his feet. But what's he going to do? DDT by Max. And now Max going for the cover. Max looking to wrap it up. And it's a very early kick out here by the tag team champs. It didn't think that was actually going to be enough, did they? Cotchalls trying to get them back into this. Oh, and a shot to the back. Oh, wait a minute. Up on the shoulders. What's Max looking to do? Samoan driver. And his brother's signature move, he just hit it. And now, looking to wrap it up, one. And it's only a one count. Hardly any damage done to the Wolfpack to wrap it up. And now attack. Brett's coming in. Brett playing to the crowd. Going crazy. Trying to get them hyped up. Oh! And that knee is just busting him open. And now they are in serious trouble here. Larrows him up and looking for a super kick. super kick, and this is a demolition display. Oh, but Brett's not going to let it end up like that way. And Brett now. Oh, and then once again a reversal. Brett is seriously hurt. He needs to get out of here. But I don't think that's going to be the case. I don't think he's going to let him. And another toss into the corner. Could be looking for the magic killer one more time. Surely this will seal the deal. To obtain the tag team championship, magic killer. And into the cover. The referee's being slow about the count, and Max got back in the ring. Oh, and now Max is in trouble. He is not happy. Samoan drop. And now he's going to go back. Oh, wait a minute. He's still going on. He's still attacking the non-legal man in a super kick. And now letting him get back to his feet. Oh, wait, not letting him get back to his feet. He's going to go for the cover again. This could be enough to become tag team champions. No, it's still not enough. Brett once again gets back to his feet. Well, not back to his feet, but at least out of the cover. Went for the super kick again. Dodged. And now, oh, wait a minute, David, with another reversal. And now David could be looking for that powerbomb onto the knee again. Oh, what a move. And surely this is enough. One, two, three. Successfully retained, but they are the first true champions. The Wolfpack with a dominant display. They tore them apart limb by limb. Magic killers galore, but in the end, it was a huge neckbreaker powerbomb that finished it off. And what a victory it was for the Wolfpack on their debuts, or their returns to the series. And the champions are here, the first champions, and that's not good because Sam gets his chance at a title later on tonight, so he could be the world champion. Could they finally do what they've been planning to do for so long and own the world title and the tag titles all at once? They've been dreaming of it for a long time. They haven't been able to do it. But Sam smiles on. He knows he has a task to do. But the boys have done their task for tonight. But what a huge victory for the Wolfpack. So in a pretty much a brutal assault of a match, the Wolfpack retain their title. But now it's time for some number one contender action. This is a six-man battle royal for the television championship, number one contendership. Yeah, that's right. They've only just won the title Sal Games, but he's going to now find out who's going to be the next in line to try and take it. First man down to the ring, Harry Austin, the younger brother of Ryan and Blake Austin, two veterans of the show. Harry never had the best of histories, but we have reset, we have refreshed, the records are set clean, and now he's looking to get himself some number one contendership action, but he's got to chuck over five men if he wants any chance of doing that. But he looks refreshed and ready to go. Can he be a potential champion? We'll soon see, but now he's got some tough competition to deal with if that's going to be the case. And the next man down to the ring is going to be someone who's going to be looking, obviously, to stop him and try and take that spot for himself. It is Mr. Money in the Bank himself, Thomas. Of course, you can't come down with the briefcase in this game because this game is shit. But Thomas now looking to come down and be the number one contender for the championship. He's already entitled to a world title shot, or any title shot for that matter, that he chooses if he chooses to cash in the Money in the Bank that he won last time at the Gamescom pay-per-view. But Thomas looking now to have another title opportunity. He could be a multi-champion if he plays all his cards right here. But there's many men looking to stop him. One of them is this man, the WWE Hall of Famer, Chris Danger. He comes down to the ring and returns once again to the show. Chris Danger looking to bring everybody into the danger zone and throw everybody out of the ring. If he does it, he's going to be a top runner for that title. Of course, he'll be number one contender. He's been looking around the mid-card section for the majority of his career. An opening card, more of a jobber he has been in the past, but now looking to push on and become a champion. Of course, he was in the Money in the Bank match, but of course, he did lose, obviously, to Thomas. And now another man looking to take that title from him. It's James Falcon, another huge YouTuber and Hall of Famer, of course, from the WWE. James Falcon looking to come down and take his spot as the number one contender of the television championship. Another person who hasn't done much in the series previously, but with the slates clean and the records reset, will he prove to be a top competitor in this business? He isn't messing around, he's just going straight down to the ring, and he knows what he has to do here tonight. He knows what he needs to do, and he's out here to do it. This is a six-man battle royal. Boy, or higher. I don't know what that means, but four men down, two more to bring out, and here comes entry number five, coming down to the ring. Who's it gonna be? It's PJ McNair on his glorious return back to the show. PJ McNair back tonight to prove a point if he can. He only was just starting out when the series came to a close. Had a total of two fights in the entirety of the show. But now he's looking for number one contendership. Looking to be a champion in this series, PJ McNair. Like I say, joined at the wrong time. YouTube was out of order and suspended it without actually telling me why they're suspending it. And they wouldn't give me my channel back either. So anyway, moving on past my bitterness, which I've shown pretty much through the entirety of this show. Let's bring down the final entrant to this six-man battle royal, which should be a good one before tonight's main event. And here he comes down to the ring, rocking custom theme music, which everyone's gonna get at some point. I just haven't given it to everybody just yet. And it's Ryan Austin coming down, the Cholton fan himself, the athlete Ryan Austin, who was also looking for title pushes towards the end of the series. Didn't quite make it in time for anything major, but now looking to prove himself in the series. Two Austin brothers once again in the ring together. And this Cholton fan looking to do England proud and be a top tier competitor in this series. But here we go, rocking that Cholton kick. That's the final man down to the ring. We are ready to go. Six men, one prize, a number one contender spot. And as what? PJ McNair's already outside the ring. So is he out? Wait, what the fuck? And Thomas is outside going, what the fuck are you doing out there? Because that's already an elimination. This match hasn't even started yet. And PJ McNair has been eliminated. That has to be literally the fastest elimination physically possible. The bell rings and he's already eliminated. What the hell? The fight's continuing. And James Falcon and Chris Danger locking up, and the two Austin brothers surprisingly locking up here. No teamwork here. PJ McNair staring down Thomas, wondering why the hell he started outside the ring, and why do I have a feeling this match isn't going to draw to a natural conclusion. But Falcon, at risk of being the first elimination, Chris Danger is going for it, and already could be doing it. Very loose on the outside, Falcon could be an early elimination here. On it's... he saves himself there. Now Harry looking to do, he's not going to keep himself in, he kept himself in, now tossing his brother over, but his brother's going to roll his way back in, or flip his way back over as it would be. Oh wait a minute, looking for a suplex was Ryan, and it reversed into a suplex from Harry. And Thomas smartly staying out of the way, but I think he's just confused. Oh, and a GTS there into a punt kick from Chris Danger. Image of Sal Games there. Jace's move there, who will be seeing in the main event, who will be competing for that world title for that one. But now, this is about number one contendership for the television championship, which was a very prestigious title back in the old series. Let's see if it will maintain its former glory. And Falcon doing some work there on Danger. It might actually be enough. Falcon progressing forward. He might actually be able to toss him over that top rope. Oh, and he has, but it's not enough. And now once again working away on him at the bottom rope, trying to eliminate him from this match. It could be a big one if someone gets out early. Thomas still just wondering why PJ McNair's outside. Maybe it's a strategy. Maybe McNair's gonna try and sneak back in at the end and try and get the final elimination. I really don't know why he's out there,
or what the hell is wrong with this shit game, but we are continuing on as it is. I'm not letting 2K or YouTube stop this. Mahoney super kick! Chris Danger with the super kick! And now to the top rope! Beautiful splash! And Falcon is in trouble here. Chris Danger making some good progression in this one. Oh, and now Chris Danger, what's he thinking? On a suplex. Thomas still refusing the move. He clearly is still in shock of what's going on outside. And now trying to pick up Harry is Ryan, and it's reversed there. That's been a tense battle going on over there. Looking to pick him up and scoop slamming me. Unable to do so. Drop kick to the younger brother. And Ryan being smart here. He knows his brother inside and out quite clearly. They both know each other very well. But let's see if either of them can use that to full effect. Meanwhile, Falcon looking to pick up the Chris Danger elimination and bring this down to five men, or four men as it would be, because PJ McGinnis already been eliminated by the looks of things. And Thomas is still not trusting him. He's just going to stare him down on the outside. Why is it when I try and make the series realistic? Stuff happens, but now Harry's going to get Thomas involved. And he sees that Thomas was distracted by McNair, just staring him down, and now Harry's going to take advantage. And looks like Ryan's going to take the shift of staring down PJ McNair now. Now Chris Danger looking to get rid of James Falcon on the outside. Falcon is in trouble, but he's able to get back inside. Now Thomas getting the beat down from Harry. And now Chris Danger once again. Oh, wait a minute. Harry going for the top rope. Could be looking for it. Could be looking for the frog splash. No, instead he's calling him up. He senses Thomas is distracted and he's using it to full advantage. Dragon Rana. Beautiful move by Harry Austin there. Little Harry Austin. The little legs himself is doing very well. Got off to a shaky start there against Harry, but decided to pick on Thomas, who was not ready for any kind of attack, as he was distracted as well. And now he's going to look to pick up an elimination. Falcon looking for an elimination himself, and Chris Danger. That battle has been happening since the start. Harry's in a bit of trouble here. Thomas has eliminated Harry! And Harry did very well to compete in that one, but he still was unable to progress forward. Four men left in this ring now. PJ McNair still on the outside, so God knows what's happening with that one. But, yeah, anyway. Oh, wait a minute, Chris Danger! Danger's eliminated Falcon! And Falcon has been eliminated. Oh, wait a minute! I think, yeah, Thomas has just been Samoan dropped out of the ring! And now Chris Danger and Ryan Austin are left in the ring. Hurricane Rana, what is PJ McNair planning? He's just still outside watching as three eliminations have just happened. Harry Austin, James Falcon, and Mr. Money in the Bank Thomas has all been eliminated. And now Chris Danger and Ryan Austin are left in the matchup. And you just can't make this stuff up with this game, I swear to God. But Chris Danger now, picking him up. Reversal by Ryan. He gets himself out of the way. And this is interesting. What does Ryan plan to do? Chris Danger. These two are attacking these two men. Kick to the gut. An uppercut. And now, freaking. Now, Ryan, I just realized that was pretty cool. And now, Chris Danger looking to pick up the final elimination. This is technically for the win. This is for the television championship. Remember, eliminating him from over the top rope is how it's done. Which is why I'm curious if PJ McNair is legally disqualified or not, or what's going on with it. But now Ryan, looking to pick up the victory. Looking to toss Chris Danger over. He's got him leaning on that back rope. Ryan, to become the number one contender. He's been a contender before. Can he do it again? Chris Danger is not out yet. PJ McNair, where is he? Wait a minute! PJ McNair's back in the ring! PJ McNair is back in the ring! And I don't think Ryan's realized yet. Nobody's even realized he's still letting him battle. Chris Danger fighting off, and PJ McNair is back in the ring, and no one's even realized. What is McNair doing? GTS! Punt kick! And PJ McNair in the ring. Oh, wait a minute. And now he's going for Chris Danger. Chris Danger hasn't even realized that he's in the ring yet. Unbelievable scenes, and PJ McNair has avoided three eliminations. And is now deciding to get into the ring when both men have weakened each other. And now McNair and Ryan seem to be working together to wear down Chris Danger. I cannot believe what I am seeing. I don't know if this was on purpose. I swear to God that I did not plan for this.
And now, oh wait a minute, McNair in danger. Oh, and a knee down there. And unbelievable, this is incredible. I cannot believe what I'm seeing. In the history of playing this game, I have never seen anything like it. But now Ryan, gonna try and get rid of the cheater McNair. But McNair nowhere near ready to be eliminated just yet. This is like a Royal Rumble, the way he's just walked in here. And now Danger's gonna try and pick up the elimination. McNair's just gonna let him bring it down to two men. And Ryan's in trouble. He's dangling, one foot's near the ground. He could be out here. Ryan could be out of this one. I cannot believe what's going on right now. Chris Danger looking to pick it up, and he still hasn't done it. Ryan, neither feet touch the ground. Now Ryan dragging Danger to the middle of the ring. And do you know what? I can't tell whether it was what's happened at all, but it's been pretty impressive from McNair, but he's been able to unload any offense, really. And now Ryan, once again, trying to look to pick up that elimination on McNair, or at least wear him down, but Danger to the rescue on a springboard into a neckbreaker from PJ McNair, who you could call a cheat. To be honest, I'd call him a freaking genius, because if I knew how to do that, I'd be freaking doing that every time I was in this matchup. But that's incredible. That is truly incredible. PJ McNair struggling to lay any offense down, and now Ryan and Danger have realized what they need to do, I think, and they need to start wearing them down. Springboard into a drop kick. Oh, wait a minute now, Ryan's going to turn his attention to Danger, maybe? No, he's just going to back off, smart move. Super kick! Super kick! And I think that's what McNair was waiting for and was trying to avoid. But now Ryan, he's going to look to pick up the elimination. I went PJ McNair, trying to go for it. And McNair, maybe this clever strategy he's come up with clearly isn't going to work. Three men left. Falcon, Thomas, and Harry Austin have all been eliminated. I think about that last one. This is incredible, honestly. This game never fails to surprise me. And now Ryan, beautiful move there. And Ryan and Danger have been locking into battle for quite a while. PJ McNair has had his moments of trying to get involved, but nothing has actually worked out for him. Reversal there for the power bomb. And now Chris Danger, he's going to look to do some more offense. Could be looking for the elimination, but no. It's on a reversal, the suplex. And now Danger, fired up right now. Could look to do some more damage to McNair, looking for a Falcon Arrow. And a beautiful Falcon Arrow suplex there. And now Ryan, gonna look to pick up the elimination. Chris Danger on the outside. Ryan senses that Danger is weakened, but Danger gets back in pretty quickly. Not gonna risk hanging around on the outside. This has been one hell of a match, and this is all for the television championship. And PJ McNair. Oh! And a lovely little move there. And Danger stomping away on Ryan McNair smartly. He's just going to let these two compete. Oh, but now he's going to try and get the elimination. Danger saves himself. But McNair kind of lets him up by the looks of things. Oh, and a couple of shots there by Danger. McNair now. Oh, the reversal by Danger. Now Danger looking to lay some more offense down. Ryan's going to get back involved. And now Ryan's going to look for the elimination. And McNair's going to help him. Ryan and McNair double teaming to get rid of Chris Danger. Chris Danger has been in top form, but now he's gone. McNair and Ryan Austin left in the ring after McNair smartly left it till the last two men to get back in the ring. McNair with the reversal, went for the clothesline, turned into a freaking Alabama slam. I forgot what the move was called there. And Ryan playing to the crowd. He senses he's in control. What's Ryan thinking? Oh, he's going to go for the elimination. Oh, but McNair, not ready just yet. He has been super kicked, but he's not ready yet. Oh, never mind. He's just been busted open from a neck breaker. How is that even possible? We found a way, and now Ryan stomping on the body parts. He's sensing this is coming to the end. And we could be seeing the beginning of the end. This is four, once again, number one contendership for the television championship. It is all to play for. It's these two men left in this match. And although McNair has been in here the least, he is the first to be busted open in a clothesline. He's trying to stop the momentum shift there from Ryan Austin. And now Ryan, once again, could be looking for the elimination. Ryan's going for it again. McNair is in serious trouble when he gets back in the match. Trying to mount some offense of his own. Ryan, once again going for the elimination. He's not ready to wrap this one up just yet. Oh, he is ready to wrap this one up. And this is really tense. Ryan looking to win. Ryan wins! And even though he tried to cheat, even though he was came in once three people had been eliminated, PJ McNair still couldn't pull together the victory. And Ryan Austin has just pulled off an incredible victory. Don't know why we're looking at the stage there on the replay. But Ryan Austin is the new number one contender for the Television Championship. The athlete Ryan Austin with a huge victory. An incredible match. I can't believe what I've seen, and that is one hell of a match. And you can't get any better than that anywhere else other than World Internet Wrestling. Let's move on, finally, to the main event. Well, it has been one hell of a night, but it is time for the main event. Can the Wolfpack finally get every title for every competitor? The World Internet World Championship is finally on the line, and Jace and King Sam are about to go at each other. First man down to the ring is... I don't know who's coming down to the ring first, actually. But they're coming down to the ring now, whoever it is. Both men, former champions. The only other champion that has been the world champion is Blake Austin. But of course, Blake Austin is general manager, as he said at the beginning of the show. And here comes King Sam. I thought it was King Sam. The leader of the Wolfpack, the creator of the Wolfpack, and the first ever World Internet Wrestling Champion when it was back called World YouTube Wrestling. But here he comes down to the ring, the leader of the Wolfpack now, making his way down to the ring. He senses the momentum with the Wolfpack. They just need to pick up the one victory. If he wins this, not only will he once again become a champion, become the first champion for the series, the Wolfpack will have both the tag team titles and the World Championship in their grasp, and they will fully be in control of it all right there. Oh, and Jace now. Jace knows that he has to defend his title here, choosing not to come down with the title once again, but Jace was never one for coming down with the title. But he is the champion as we know him to be, and the Warrior Jace knows the task he has at hand. He's been through this match before, Jace and King Sam. I'm pretty sure it was Jace that took the title from King Sam. So it's not like this is going to be a pushover of a battle. Jace knows what he has to do. King Sam and him have faced each other very well. No Wolfpack in attendance to this matchup. I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, this is a no disqualification match. I could be wrong on that one. And this is what it's for. The World Internet Wrestling World Championship, or the WIW World Championship, as that sounds a lot nicer than repeating the word world twice.
Introducing the challenger from London, England, weighing in at 178 pounds, the King Sam.
King Sam. One of the best in the business. The best in the business, in my opinion.
Introducing the champion from Lisbon, Portugal, weighing in at 220 pounds, he is the World Internet Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, Jason Carter Emerson, the Punisher.
Jace, ready to go. Looking to defend that title. He's the last champion, which is why he brings it down to the ring. No Wolfpack at ringside. And Jace reluctantly hands over the World Championship to the referee. This is a big one for the biggest prize in the business. King Sam will take on Jace. Who will be victorious? We'll find out. Let's get this on the way, and straight away they both run at each other and both looking to mount some offense. King Sam though, quick to reverse. And now King Sam with a curb stomp. And taunting to the crowd straight off the bat. Sensing early control, or at least getting in his head. But Jace is up and ready to go. And a knee to the face. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, and a knee And Sam off with some early offense and chucks him out of the ring and continues to taunt. And the champion, of course, Jace, the last champion of the business. Oh, and a beautiful springboard there. Didn't get all of it, but enough to do the damage. Jace, the last champion. Sam, the champion before that one. And King Sam was a very good champion. And as the Wolfpack leader, he has led his team to two tag team titles, or as it will be now, their only tag team title, the first ever tag team champions. A quick recap of everything that has happened to this point for those who have missed it. King Sam and Jace going for the world title right now. In the last match of a six-man battle royal, which Ryan Austin won number one contendership rights. Oh, wait a minute, weapons are coming out. This is a no disqualification. Falls counts anywhere. That's why the referee is following them. And King Sam with a huge move. And he could be looking to wrap it up there. He feels this is enough. One, and it's only a one count. Now King Sam, he's going to grab the chair. Oh, but a reversal. Oh, wait a minute. A chuck into the barricade. And I can't even talk about the other matches because this match is going crazy. These two fighting each other to the death right now. Went for a cutter, unable to land it. Another reversal. Neither of these two giving an inch in this one. DDT. And this is ridiculous. The tension. Oh, wait a minute. Looking for white noise. White noise. White noise from Jace. And now Jace looking to finish this one off. King Sam's in trouble here. This could be all over. Looking to wrap it up. Scoops him up. Oh, and splats him down. That could be over. The referee taking his time to come and get it. One. And it's only a two count. Jace thought it was over. And it wasn't just yet. Jace has got a task ahead of him. Because Sam isn't going down without a fight. Oh, and Jace once again with the reversal. Jace proving a serious problem. Oh, and knees down. Bringing him down. And these camera cuts are really killing my eyes right now. I've got to tell you. Because he just keeps changing. Elbow to the back of the head. And Jace looking for the belly to belly. Oh! And on the concrete, this is doing extra damage. Reverses the kick. Oh, wait a minute. Grabs his leg. And now King Sam looking to get back into this one. Doing damage to that leg. And now what's Sam thinking? Sam's going to look under the ring. And it looks like nothing's under there. And there isn't. That's not good. King Sam not going to give him a second. Missed the clothesline. Oh, no. Oh, and a zigzag. And these two. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, and looking to wrap this one up. Jace looking to win this. Jace could be champion right here. Jace looking to tap him out. Looking to tap him out. And it could be enough. Jace trying to get King Sam. But King Sam just going to pick him up. Trusting him out. He's not going to let him do it. Oh, but wait a minute, now he's going to try and steal the cover. Looking to wrap it up on. The referee took too long to get over and break the count. And now looking for a chair shot and straight to the face. And now them chair shots wearing him down. He senses Jace has been in control and the chair shots coming into effect. He throws down the chair. King Sam now looking to get in control of this match. Gets him up on the shoulders. Oh, what a move! And that could be over. The cover to become the world champion one more time. No, it's a two count. And Jace refuses to give in. King Sam must be wondering what he has to do at this point. Irish whip into the barricade. Oh, and wait a minute, look to probably do something with the barricade, but reversal and another reversal, and Jace now in trouble. Needs to do something. Suplex. And now King Sam looking for the cover in one hell of a main event. This is. I don't know why I just repeated this is like that, but interesting choice. And now what's he thinking? I can't really see what's going on. But it looks like he's doing some damage there to the arm. What's he thinking? Oh, I see what that was. Yeah, trying to snap the arm and now getting to the top rope. Now what's he thinking? King Sam turns around. And now he's calling him back to his feet. And Jace is in real trouble if he can't do something about it. Oh my god! Trouble in Paradise! Trouble in Paradise! What a kick! Unbelievable! And this could steal it! This could steal it! Jace should be calling the champion! It's still a two count! It's still a two count! Unbelievable! Sam refusing to give in! Oh, and now I'm going to use that chair. Frustration from the current champion. I bet Sam, he gets up. Sam reverses. And now picking him up. What do you think? Oh, kick to the gut. Oh, and another kick to the gut. And a clothesline. And this has been one hell of a match. Sam thinking that's enough. One, two, and it's a two count. Both of these two were the closest of a two count. And a kick to the back of the head. Sam sensing control. Or at least trying to get back into control. Irish whip chucking him down the ring. I went for the kick. Jace was able to reverse it. And brings him down instead. And now Jace looking to mount some offense. Reversal. And another reversal. Jace now trying to get back in control of this one. He lost control. And now taking this up to the ramp, it seems. Oh, wait a minute. They missed. Oh, and a reversal there by Jace. And these two going back and forth, refusing to give in. King Sam now in trouble. Could be looking for that GTS. Oh, instead he's going for a powerbomb, it looks. Oh, no, he's going for this move again. I don't even know what this one is. But Jace has busted him open. It's over. It's got to be over. One, two, and no, still kicks out. He still kicks out, and Jace can't believe it. Jace cannot believe that this match is not over. And now, looking to make him tap, looking to become champion, looking to wrap it up. It's going to all be over. King Sam's in trouble. King Sam is in serious trouble right now. Fighting with all the energy he has left to stay in this one. Oh my god, he's holding this in for so long. What a match this is right now. Jace in full control. But wait a minute, Sam. Sam gets up.
Oh god, his body's been through hell and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And Sam needs to do something seriously now. Oh, and a drop on the knee. Oh, and a beautiful move. And once again now, while he's down, damage done to the knee. Looking to steal the cover. Ref coming round to try and steal this match, and it's only a two count. King Sam refusing to give in. Jace refusing to give in. They continue to move further up the ramp. And now King Sam back on the shoulders. Looking for that attitude adjustment again. He's done it. He's done it. And that could be enough. The cover. King Sam looking to wrap it up. One, two. No, it's a two count. And that could have been a new champion right there. And it's still not enough. And Sam playing to the crowd, kind of lying to them, telling he's in control. But what a match this has been. And for the world title, wait a minute. A sledgehammer. Oh, and he missed the sledgehammer shot. And now Jace is going to not use the title by the freaking, what's it called? Oh, the reversal. Looking for the sledgehammer is what I meant to say. And this is crazy. This match has been going on for a while. Reversal of the sledgehammer shot again. Oh, and he nearly ran into it. Just stopped himself before he could. Oh, and he went for the clothesline. Reversal again. Another reversal. And these two are going hammer and tong right now. Quite literally with the hammer pot. A cover again. Looking to wrap this one up. Looking to become the world champion. No, it's a two count again. And this is crazy. These guys refusing to give in and out. Thinking of every hurt tactic he can. Sam looking to finish this one off. Oh, and with the steel steps, he misses. Oh! Oh my word, the damage that must have done with that running stair shot. Oh, and Jace getting worn down. That's surely it. Good night, Jace. King Sam becoming the new champion. No! It's still not enough.
There's no keeping this guy down tonight.
Chase refusing to give in. Oh, and he chucks him over them stairs.
He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen.
Oh, wait a minute. Sam's running away. Sam running up the ramp, turns around, just trying to give himself some breathing room, it looks. And this match is just escalating all over the place. But what a match this has been. This has worn both of them out. Sam's going to try and steal the cover, but the referee's nowhere. Oh, wait, he's still going to make the pin, though.
Gets the shoulder up.
And still gets the shoulder.
It's going to take more than that to keep him down tonight.
Oh, the reversal by Jace. Oh, wait a minute. Jace is going for it again. And Sam is in trouble if it hits. Oh, it's surely over. It's surely over. The referee coming up to get him. One, two. No, it's still a two. It's still a two, and Jace cannot believe it. What does Jace have to do to wrap this one up? What's Jace going to do now? Looks like Jace wants to bring this back in the ring. Jace is sensing the beginning of the end. And he wants to wrap it up where it started in the ring. Incredible lag right now. I have no idea what's going on. Sam's taunting. And I don't think he can believe the fact that he actually is taunting him right now. But he picks up the steel steps.
The champion is in serious jeopardy here tonight. I don't think I've ever seen a more determined challenger.
Oh!
Still being used to tenderize their
opponent. The steps still in use. Sam wearing him down, and what a vicious match this has been. Looking to use it again. Oh, and he misses. Oh, wait, now Jace. Jace takes the steps from him. Puts it down and stomps on him. And this is proper aggression at its finest. Oh, an uppercut! Flying uppercut! And this is surely enough now. Sensing it's enough. But wait a minute, Kingston still gets up. Irish whip into the barricade. King Sam is brutally busted open. And shots to the head on that barricade. This is crazy stuff right now. Now King Sam sensing the beginning of the end, or maybe not. He's getting him up. Just getting him up right now into the barricade. Is he going to do something? No! Jace able to stop him. Jace with a clothesline. I'm losing the last of his energy here. Both men just trying to wrap it up. But wait a minute, King Sam. Another reversal. And now once again, going back to them steps, he's favoured the steps tonight. Oh, and he lays them down with the stairs. No, oh, and misses. Brutal stuff from King Sam. Misses. Oh, and he's run into him. Run into the steel chair shots. Trying to put it down there. Hesitated. Oh! And on the back. The cover. And the referee's all the way around there still. The cover, though. To become the champion. No, it's still not enough. It's still a two count. This is insane. Nobody is giving an inch. Tossing him up. And King Sam in control. I can barely... I can't imagine the pain that these guys must be going through right now. Sam busted open to bits. Playing with the competition. Oh, wait a minute. Where's he going? Sam is playing. He's calling him up. He wants him to come over. He wants him to come and follow him. But Jace is taking some serious damage and now taunting with the crowd. He senses he's in control of this one. Now Jace playing Chase. King Sam making him follow him, making him come and get him, walks through the barrier there that apparently is just an invisible prop there. Oh! And he's playing it smart, making him play Chase and then assaulting him and a clothesline. And Jace, reversal there by Jace. He's not going to let him get away with this, Chase. And now stomping on him. What is King Sam going to do? Oh, and King Sam is in trouble. And now Jace, sensing the end, looking to finish it off. King Sam is in serious trouble. No, he's reversed it. He's reversed it. And now King Sam. Taunting again. Jace must have no energy left. And King senses that. The King looking for the cover, but the referee's miles away. Cover from the ref. Two. It's only a two count. And that must have been about a seven count. In reality. Oh, and tossed into the ringside area, or the ramp area. Can he jump? Oh, he's jumped! Oh, my days! I didn't even know he could do that! Holy shit! Oh, my days, he jumped! I was just like, can he jump? I didn't know if he could do it. That could be enough. One, two, no, it's still a two count! We can't even see what's going on down there. And the referee and Sam getting up. And I don't know what they can do up here anymore. This is crazy. Jace trying to get up. This has been brutal. This has been one of the best matches I've ever seen. And I've said that a lot tonight. And that's just showing how amazing this match has been. Jace needs to get up if he can. But Sam's not going to make it easy for him with kicks. Oh, no. Oh, wait a minute. Jace looking to steal it. Jace looking to steal it. Oh, and onto the stage lights. It's over. It is over here. Jace, one, two. No, it's still not enough. Jace is convinced that was a three count. And where is Jace going now? King Sam refusing to give in here. Fighting with his last breath. King Sam crawling back to his feet. People have been wanting to see these guys go. But Jace get back up. Throwing a kick as he gets up. This has been brutal. I cannot believe it that this is going on. Sam, with all his strength and energy, no Wolfpack help, is fighting to the end in this one. Reversal by Sam. And now Sam needs to do something here. Just backs up. Oh, wait. Misses the clothesline again. And instead an uppercut. Throwing a clothesline. Oh, and Jace wouldn't let him help. Let Sam help him up, it seems. Oh, wait. Looking for the clothesline. And a reversal. Into his own clothesline. The cover. Jace is in trouble. This could be the end of the match. And it's only a two count. Neither of these two giving an inch. Shot to the back. I cannot believe what we're seeing here. This has been brutal. Sam needs to wipe off the blood at some point. Oh! Oh, and a reversal there. Tossing him over. And Sam is in trouble. Wait a minute. Sam again with the reversal. And the crowd are going mental. Reversal by Jace. And now Jace looking to wrap it up. Looking to finish it off, surely. For the fifth time. A glory bomb is the ref calling it. One, two, three, it's over. Jace has successfully retained and become the first champion of the series in probably what was already match of the year. Jace comes back to the ring to get his title. And you know what? He deserves it for that. Unbelievable. Jace defends the world title, and that is going to end the show. A five-star match, the greatest of all time. What a match. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching episode one of the new channel. Please sure to subscribe to the network and show us some ratings with some thumbs up, and that'll be so much appreciated. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace.